In this video lecture, we're going to look at the structure of the atmosphere. Now, the atmosphere can be divided into three different categories. The first category would be composition. Composition meaning, how is it made up? All right, we can divide the atmosphere into how the atmosphere is, how it's made up, okay? And then we've got temperature. So we can categorize the atmosphere according to its temperature, the different temperatures, increasing or decreasing temperature. And then the final one would be function. How does it function? How does the particular shells in this category of the atmosphere function? All right, what are their purposes? Okay, so let's go ahead and draw with me three column. We're going to do a box here, which shows a cutaway, if you will, of the atmosphere. And then we've got three columns. This would be composition, this would be temperature, and this would be function. All right, we'll start with the composition category first. Now, I just want to make sure you understand that this is the surface. So we've got a couple of mountains here. We've got the setting sun, etc., just so that everyone knows that this is the surface of the Earth. Okay, so this is the surface. SFC is the surface. All right, for a composition, there are only two shells. The first shell is the homosphere. Okay, and that's the one that's closest to the surface of the Earth. The homosphere. Here, the gases mix well. This is why we're here. This is why we are able to live in this shell, because we breathe in not just oxygen, but we breathe in hydrogen, nitrogen, argon, helium, all these things we're inhaling. And so we can live in this because the homosphere, the gases mix well. On the opposite side of this, and to further away from the surface, is the heterosphere. In the heterosphere, the gases do not mix well. And so what happens is they're layered according to their atomic weight. All right, so the heavier gases are going to be closer to the surface of the Earth, but in this shell. Okay, so those are only two shells in the atmosphere. The first one is the homosphere, where the gases mix well, and the heterosphere, they do not mix well. Now we move on to temperature. There are four major shells and three minor shells. Okay? And they're based on temperature, the temperature profile of each shell. Okay? Now, I'm going to down here along the surface, I'm going to put cool, or really cold, and warm. Because we're making this a graph, okay? We're going to make this a graph. The shell that we're closest, that we live in, is called the troposphere. It's the troposphere. The temperature in this shell decreases with altitude. The temperature decreases with altitude. So like a graph, we're showing that the temperature at the surface is warm, and then when we get to the top of the troposphere, it gets cold. Alright, now temperature stays the same, or relatively the same, as we increase in altitude. Okay, and when it does this, when the temperature doesn't change very much for a distance, then it's what we call a pause. In this case, we're going to call this the tropopause. The tropopause. All right, so this acts like a lid. There's temperature inversion. A temperature inversion is like this. This is a temperature inversion, where you go one direction and then you shift. This is the inversion. That is the point where it changes direction. We could go the other way. This, the temperature, or the temperature is warming up, and then it shifts, so there's a temperature inversion there. That's what's happening with these pauses. There's a temperature inversion at the pause. It acts like a lid. Okay. So then we increase in temperature here. And this is what we call the major shell, the stratosphere. Where temperature increases with altitude. It warms back up with altitude. And then temperature doesn't change very much, so it's another pause. It's another point of inversion. And so we call this the stratopause. The stratopause. All right, then we get into the mesopause. Oh, I'm sorry, mesosphere. I'm jumping right ahead. Woo! Jumping right ahead. Mesosphere. Mesosphere, a major shell, and the temperature decreases with altitude, similar to the troposphere, okay? But the temperature decreases and it's much more colder. Okay, another inversion, the mesopause. Now we get to the mesopause. So we have the mesosphere, the mesopause, temperature doesn't change very much. And then finally, the temperature increases in the last shell, and this is what we refer to as the thermosphere, the heat sphere. Notice I've got this dashed line up here. The dashed line indicates that really we cannot measure the temperature here because the molecules are so far apart. Okay, in order to measure heat, with a thermometer, or a traditional thermometer, the molecules have to be bouncing off and on that the bulb of the thermometer. So the faster the molecules run or move, the warmer it is. Okay, the slower they move, the colder it is. Okay, so up here, molecules are so far apart. Down toward the surface, they're right next to each other. So let's go through this one more time. The troposphere, the temperature decreases with altitude. There's a less temperature change for a distance of altitude, and we call that the tropopause, then temperature inversion. And then you get in the stratosphere where the temperature increases with altitude, and then it doesn't change very much. That we call the stratopause. The mesosphere, the temperature decreases with altitude, and then we get a no change of temperature for a distance, and that is the mesopause or mesopause. And then we have a temperature inversion at the mesopause. Temperature increases with altitude with the thermosphere, in the thermosphere. Okay. Now I'm going to give you the average temperatures of each of these pauses so you can kind of gauge on the significance of them. At the tropopause is negative 57 degrees Celsius. It's quite cold. Usually if you're at cruising altitude of an airplane, you're going to be traveling within or just under the tropopause. Okay? And the temperature, the average temperature of the tropopause is around negative 57 degrees Celsius. Then in the stratopause, the temperature here is a 0 degrees Celsius. It is 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, quite a bit warmer. That's at freezing. And then the mesopause is the coldest shell, minor shell, the coldest minor shell at negative 90 degrees Celsius. So you see the temperature profile here with the temperature category. Okay. Then finally, we have two additional shells. That is function. How do these particular categorizations function in the atmosphere? This first one, there's nothing. There's nothing at the surface. But it's this one that we're most concerned with. This shell here of function is called the ozonosphere. The ozonosphere, its important function is to protect us from the harmful rays of the sun. More specifically, UVA, UVB, and UVC. So ultraviolet radiation is what we're concerned with here. Ozone, the ozonosphere has ozone in it. And what happens here is that the ozone actually absorbs UV A, B, and C and converts it to heat, okay? The ozone absorbs UV A, B, and C and converts it to heat. Anytime, remember from our previous lectures, that anytime you absorb radiation, there's heat involved. So that is why the stratosphere increases with increases temperature with height. Okay, it increases temperature with height. That is because of the ozone in the ozonosphere, which is also in the stratosphere. Okay, and then we have the ionosphere. The ionosphere deals with the electrical charge of the atmosphere. Here you can see the aurora borealis, the night lights near the poles. Sometimes if you're in the high latitudes, you can see them in winter. It's a green ribbon, green-red ribbons across the night sky. So that's the ionosphere. So of the significant aspects of the structure of the atmosphere, the homosphere, where the gases mix well, that's why we're able to live here. The heterosphere, where the gases do not mix well, but they're layered according to their atomic weight. We have this troposphere, where the temperature decreases with altitude. And then we have the tropopause, where there is very little temperature change with distance or altitude. In the stratosphere, the temperature increases with altitude because of the ozone absorbing UVA, B, and C. And then we get to the stratopause, another lid, where the temperature does not change very much with altitude. And then we get the mesosphere, where the temperature decreases with altitude. And then we get no change of temperature in the mesopause. And then we get the thermosphere, which we have an increase in temperature as we increase altitude. And then finally, function. We've already covered the ozonosphere. Ozone absorbs UV, A, B, and C. And the ionosphere, the electrical charge portion of the atmosphere. Now, I want to go back to ozonosphere. If ozone continues to be depleted, what happens is we create that ozone hole. If we lose this function, we can definitely burn to a crisp, and our climate will be extremely warmer because more radiation is reaching the surface of the Earth. So we need to make sure we maintain the integrity of the ozonosphere, or we're going to be in trouble.